I lay down before you all the pain. I lay down before you the emotion. I lay down before you the confusion. I lay down everything that is not like you. Lord God, I present myself a vessel. Make me a worthy vessel, Lord. Use me, Lord God, this morning. Use me, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you, Father. I thank you. That's the word of God. In Jesus' name. Amen. I can't see you. Message title is He Carries You Through the Darkness. And I'm going to start with some scriptures. Psalms 34. I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. My soul will boast in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify with me. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from my fears. Those who look at him are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. The poor man called and the Lord heard him. He saved him out of his troubles. The angels of the Lord encamp those who fear him. He delivers them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who takes refuge in him. And then I'm going to go down to verse 17. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all his troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. A righteous man has many troubles, but the Lord delivers them from them all. Then we will go to 2 Corinthians. 1 through 10.
12.
Yeah, I told you I can't read. Not even my own handwriting. 12, 1 through 10, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. focus down here on verse 9. I must go on boasting. Although there is nothing to be gained, I will go on visions and revelations from the Lord. I know a man in Christ who is 14 years ago caught up in the third heaven, whether it be in body or out of body, I do not know. God knows. And I know this man, whether in the body or apart from the body, I do not know, but God knows, was caught up into paradise. He heard inexpressible things that man is not permitted to tell. I will boast about a man like that, but I will not boast about myself except about my weakness. Even though I choose to boast, I would not be a fool because I would be speaking the truth, but I refrain so no one would think of me more than is what warranted by what I do or say. To keep me from becoming conceited because of these surpassingly great revelations, there was given me a thorn in my flesh, a messenger from Satan to torment me. 3 times I pleaded with the Lord to take it away from me, but he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you. My power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore I will boast all the more gladly in my weakness, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why for Christ's sake, I delight in my weakness, my insults, my hardships, my persecutions, my difficulties. When I am weak, then I am strong." I'm going to refer to the last week, because this message is pretty much my testimony.
Amen.
Those who know me know I went through this week. The best of Christians go through hard times. So, you know, what do you do when you're going through these hard times? It's easy to get caught up in the stuff. It's easy to get caught up in your trials. Sometimes these things are just so overwhelming that they can bog you down. So, you know, sometimes we write them off. Sometimes they just overwhelm you. But your first instinct is to cry to the Lord. And my grandson is crying now. As the deer pants for the streams of the water, so my soul pants for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When can I go meet with God? My tears have been my food day and night, while men say to me all day long, "Where is your God?" Say things I remember. I pour out my soul. How I used to be with the multitude, leading in procession to the house of God. I'm not going to read this whole scripture. I'm going to go down to, what did I tell you? With shouts of singing and festive songs. Why are you cast down on my soul? Why are you so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my soul and my God. I'm going to go down to chapter 6. And then I'm going to go over to Psalms 132. Because when you're going through, you have to cry out to him, because there's no one else to cry out to.
Come on.
Come on. Come on.
You can, but you're not going to get any answers.
Come on.
Thank you, Father.
And where I'm going with this is we can get depressed. Wrapped up in our problems. And that's something I know about firsthand. No matter how much we fight, no matter how much we know where to go, depression can still come along. So this is where my battle has had to come from, the depression. I cry out to the Lord. He lift my voice. I lift my voice to the Lord for mercy. I pour out my complaint before him. I tell my trouble. When my spirit grows faint within me, it is you who I know my way. In the path where I walk, men have hidden a snare for me. Look to my right and see, there's no one concerned for me. I have no refuge, no one cares for my life. I cry to you, O Lord. I say, you are my refuge. You are the portion in the land of the living. Listen to my cry. I am in desperate need. Rescue me from those who pursue me. For they are too strong for me. Set me free from my prison, that I may praise your name. When the righteous gather about me, because of your goodness for me. So when you're going through, your first initiative should be to cry to the Lord. Before you get on Facebook,
come on, come on, there we go, come on, mama.
And complain about what your mama does, or what your daddy did, or what that N word did, or that other word did.
Come on.
You can cry out to Jesus.
Come on, man, come on.
Because them 700 or 900 Facebook friends don't need to know.
Right. Come on, hold on. Cry out to Jesus. Come on.
All
that's
right.
Come on. It's the real deal.
It's
trying to get in our mailbox today.
I mean, now, as I go on, I would get to in my message, I would tell you, there are people you can talk to. But your first instinct should be to cry out to Jesus. Because even when you don't know how to handle it, even when you don't know the words to say, cry out to him. Just these psalms, the reason why I like the psalms so much is because they have prayers like the ones I've read that you can read. They're prayers. You don't have to say, oh, Father God, I am in trouble. Will you help me with this? Will you help me with that? If you don't know how to pray, pray these scriptures.
Amen.
There's many in here. Just pray the scriptures.
Come on.
God knows your heart.
Yes.
Pray these scriptures. Read them out loud. And that's crying out to him. Mm-hmm. I've got one of my own little crying out here that I wrote several years ago.
Oh, wow.
And it's called The Rope.
Come on.
How long do you hold on when you just can't hold on any longer? When you have come to the end of your rope. That same rope that you've been holding on to what seems like forever. The ends are worn and frayed, yet you continue to hold on. The hands that used to be silky soft are now hard and calloused, rough from the fibers of the rope that's been tearing into your flesh as you grasp it with all of your might. The heart that was once so quick to forgive is now filled with bitterness, guarded and afraid. By both hands, you're hanging on by this thread, trying not to let go as pain grips your entire being. Your shoulders are sore as your arms seem to have come out of their sockets from the weight of your body. With the weight of your burdens, you begin to get out of sorts, bent out of joint with everyone who crosses your path. You fight not to lose your grip as this rope sways side to side with the winds of the life blowing. Darkness covers you, now has you engulfed you, swallowing you whole, burying you. You know that it's only a smoke screen, not real, certainly not as bad as it seems. But your vision is impaired. All you can see is the big black cloud hovering over your head. That one problem, that one obstacle that is blocking your dreams. Then, suddenly you hear a soft, mighty thunder. Softest music from the heavens. Dangling in midair, you see a hint of sunlight shining through. You see God looking down from heaven. In his left hand, he has a firm grip. In the other hand, you have been at the end of. His other hand, his mighty right hand stretched out beneath you, he smiles and says, let go. Let go of the rope, I've got you. I'm here to catch you. Let go of your worries, the pain, the bitterness, which you have been holding on to. Turn it loose. I never told you to hold on to this rope. I asked you to hold on to my hand.
That's good. That's good.
Amen.
Yeah, that was good.
Come on. Amen.
After you cry out to the Lord, you meditate on scripture and song. This was my past week. God was preparing me for a sermon that I didn't know I was going to prepare for. So.
Amen.
Okay, Psalms 119, 25 through 32. I am laid down low in the dust. Preserve my life according to your word. I recounted my ways, and you answered me. Teach me your decrees. Let me understand your teaching and your precepts. Then I will meditate on your wonders. My soul is weary with sorrow. Strengthen me according to your word. Keep me from deceitful ways. Be gracious to me through your law. I have chosen the way of truth. I have set my heart on your laws.
Yes.
I hold fast to your statutes, O Lord. Yes. Do not let me be put to shame. I run in the path of your commands. You have set my heart free. You meditate on God's word. Once again, you can go right to these same scriptures. And you meditate on how he delivers, how he's delivered other people. You meditate on the scriptures, and you can meditate on Psalm. Let's see, Ephesians 5, 19 has a quick verse on that. Speak to one another in psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. And this one here says, sing and make music in your heart to the Lord. One of my favorite things to do is I don't sit down. I don't kneel. I pace the floor. This is a thing I got, some little thing my dad used to do, and I kind of do it. I listen to my music, and I pray, and I pace the floor. I listen to my music. My granddaughter will tell you, my grandkids, they sing with me. And I will just sing. I'll get caught up in the spirit. And that is my praise. That is my worship. That is my time with God. And that gets me through some of the hardest times in my life. And that is, and I have felt God just literally carry me, literally carry me. Bad times. There is times when I have felt the presence of God physically. I have felt God's arms around me because of scripture and music. I have felt Him cover me with a blanket. I have laid on the floor and prayed in prayer, and I felt a thick blanket of His pray, of His presence just cover me when I was going through a terrible time. It's real. It's real. And I'm talking about going through those dark moments, going through those times when you feel like you just can't make it anymore. Going through those times when you want to call it quits. Going through those times when you don't know if you want to continue living. Going through those times when you don't know if you can physically or emotionally handle it anymore.
Come on.
And I know that God will cover you. When nobody else can give you a hug, when nobody else's hug can do it for you,
come on.
I know that God will physically cradle you in His arms. He's done it for me before. He's doing it for me right now, and He will continue to do it for you.
Yes.
And so you just have to rest in His arms, and He will carry you through your darkest moments. So meditate on His scripture. Soak up His presence. Absorb His presence. Surrender and die out to self. And the inability to do it on your own, because we can't do it on our own. This past week I have wanted to make things happen like that, because things weren't happening the way I wanted them to. And I wanted them to happen just like this. I wanted to make phone calls, make it work, instead of just resting in peace, knowing that God got it, even though I knew He had it. But I wanted to make it happen. I wanted to make it happen. But I had to surrender and let God do it for me, and let God just give me that peace and die out to self. And during these times when you're resting in His presence, when you're surrendering out to God, then you can take that second step, which is encourage yourself by these same scriptures. By these same scriptures, you read them out loud. You're reading them out loud. You're meditating on them. You're meditating on scripture. You're meditating on song. And then the next step is to encourage yourself. You speak them out loud and you encourage yourself. So then by that same time, you're not crying, you're not depending so much on that blanket, but you're encouraging yourself and you're lifting yourself up. And you know that you can go like this now, I can sit down. And you're lifting up and you can speak it forth, and you know that you've got it. You know that you've got that peace. You know that God has got you.
Come on.
So see, it just goes from one step to the other. But if you know, you got to stop people. You're going through this stuff, and you're saved, and you've got Christ. What about those people that don't have
Him? Come on. There you go.
Now you're speaking.
What about those people that don't have Him? So then you're going to wonder, well, why am I going through this? I was going through a terrible week. I'm telling you guys, that's my daughter. We went through a rough week. She'll say amen real loud, but she's not going to stand for herself. She's not trying to draw attention to herself. But then why do you go through it, and then I get this phone call?
Why do you go through
it? She said, "Mom, you're supposed to preach."
That's all right.
But it's real, you know. As they say, the struggle is real. I love them. I love her. But Then you can speak to that mountain.
Come on.
And you can tell it to get on in that sea.
Come on.
And it'll move out of your way. But in the same time, you're staying awake, staying with positive people. I mean, you don't just talk your problems. There's people that you know that will encourage you and pray for you.
Yeah.
You don't just talk to anybody.
Talk to somebody.
But yes, sometimes you have to. You have to have that person to lift you up because, you know, they'll be calling you when they need it too.
Amen.
And most of all, you've got to praise. And there's scriptures in there for that too. You know, if you don't know how to praise, there's a scripture for that. If you don't know how to praise. And there's my favorite in there. I used to, and I still do, when the opportunity presents itself, praise dance. And there's a scripture that I learned at that time. And that's 150. I will praise the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in his mighty expanse. Oops, I'm reading wrong. Praise him in his mighty heavens, praise him in his acts of power, praise him in his surpassing greatness, praise him in his surrounding trumpets, praise him with the harp and lyre, praise him with the tambourine and dancing, praise him with the strings of flute. Praise him with the flashy cymbals. Praise him with the resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. So with every step that I'm giving you, it's all in the scripture. If you don't know how to physically, verbally do these prayers, if you don't know the prayers, it's all in the Bible. And a lot of it's in Psalms. That's where I, before I knew the word, as much as I do, that's how I prayed my way through. I prayed scriptures.
Yes.
But, and I will also say, why are you going through your troubles?
Come on.
Why are you going through your troubles?
Come on.
You know, you always say, why me? Why me? Why do I still have this problem? Why do I still have a car trouble? Hmm. Why don't I have a husband? Why don't I have a, that's not me, of course. Why am I going through this financial problem? Why am I going through depression? Why am I going through bipolar? Why am I going through, whatever. There's many things that I've gone through in my life, and later on down the line, I've had people come to me with that very same problem that I've been able to minister to.
Yeah.
And
God has a reason for it. God brings, you know, if you surrender your problems to him, if you surrender your life to him, God will use that very problem to help somebody else.
Yes. Yes.
Because there's somebody that doesn't have Christ as you do. Because just like I just mentioned, that if you can imagine not having the problems and not knowing Christ and knowing him to carry you through, what about that person that don't know Christ? But by you knowing Christ, by you being able to have that faith, there's something you can give somebody else.
Amen.
And there's a way, wisdom and guidance that you can give somebody else as they walk through that
Amen.
Same problem.
Amen.
Amen.
God is carrying you through to prepare you. Like I said, this past week was like preparing me for something that I didn't know he was. He was giving me scripture, Psalms, and I had no idea what he was doing. There's people out there that God wants you to reach while you're going through your situation, while you're complaining, why me? There's somebody out there that is worse off than you.
Mm. Yes.
I would like to go to James 1, 2 through 8. And this is a scripture that came to me this past week. Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials and of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. Perseverance must finish its work, so that you may mature and complete, not lacking anything. If anything, if any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God, who gives you generously without finding fault, and it will be given to him. But when he lacks, he must believe and not doubt, because he who doubts is like a wave of sea blown, tossed by the wind. Like man should not think he will receive anything from the Lord. He is double-minded and unstable in all his ways. So, I'm grateful for my trial. There's other things that I've gone through that I thank God for, because I know it's made me the woman that I am. And I've grown spiritually. And I've grown mature. I've matured. I'm not where I should be. I'm not where I'm going to be. But I thank God for where I am. I thank God for where he's taking
me. That's it.
And I give God the praise and the glory. I am thankful. I submit each one of my problems to him. I submit my failures to him.
Come on.
I submit my depression to him.
Come on.
For those of you who struggle with depression, it's real.
Yes.
It's not a weakness.
Amen.
It's not anything to be ashamed of. It's a struggle. Because while I was struggling with mine this past week, I could feel God doing this. I had the same mind. I could feel God doing this. I had this light. I had this light in my mind. And God was doing this. While my mind emotions was over here doing something else, God was doing this.
Yes.
I was not ashamed. I'm not ashamed, because I know. I know that God's got me. I know God that carries me through. And I know that because of my depression and because of my being, I don't claim it. But the bipolar that I'm being treated for.
Come on now, say it.
I know that God is going to use
that to break it
in somebody else. And I speak to anybody who is dealing with these issues. Do not be ashamed. Do not be ashamed. God will deliver you as he is delivering me. God will deliver you because he is delivering me. He is delivering me as I speak. As I speak, he is delivering me because I speak it. God wants you to speak it out loud. The enemy wants you to keep it quiet. The enemy wants you to be ashamed.
I'm not up here for no reason. I'm not standing here for no reason. God is my deliverer. God sets me free. God is my deliverer.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Woo!
Father, we speak into the atmosphere right now, God, that you will have your way. Father, we thank you right now, God, that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. God, as the word that she has declared over her life, God, we thank you, God, that she has proclaimed that word, God. God, as Mother Deborah has spoken that word right now, God, I speak in the name of Jesus, God, that she's free. God, that no weapon, no weapon, no weapon, no weapon, no weapon, no weapon, from this point of God shall come before her, God. Because out of her mouth, out of her mouth, God, she spoke deliverance, God, she spoke healing. And I thank you, God. I thank you, God, for healing from the top of her crown to the bottom of her feet. So I speak to you right now.
Your heart.
I come against the struggle that has even been inside your heart.
Yes.
I come against that, I come against that hurt and that pain. Even though, Dominic, even sometimes you seem to carry that joy, but yet inside you're still hurting because of things you're carrying.
Come on.
And you've been carrying this thing for a long time. You have got it buried down deep inside. Woo! But Dominic, it's time for you to be free. Free in your, woo! So that you can understand the true value of who you are. Of who you are, because it not only affects you, but it affects your children. It affects you, it affects your children, because you are, gosh, you have been through hell and back. So many things have tried to burden you down and have tried to hurt you, Dominique. And girl, you have been through storm after storm after storm. You've even been through times where you have wondered, God, how am I going to make it? But I'm telling you, God, listen. God is going to bring some order into the family because you're going somewhere. Your mother's, it's time for you to pick it back up. Whatever it is that you're supposed to pick up, God said, pick it back up. Whatever it is that you're supposed to pick it up, God said, pick it up. Because when you pick it up, it's your answer to what you need. Whatever it is that you got to pick up, God says, pick it up. Because it's time for you to pick it up, because that is your answer. You've been fighting against your answer because sometimes it feels like you don't want to pick it up because you don't know how to pick it up, because it seems like, God, I can't do it anymore, God, because my hands is weak, God, my body is weak, God, my mind is weak, God, I can't do this, God. God says, no, it's time to pick it up. Whatever it is that you got to pick up, pick it up. It might seem hard. I don't know if it's your painting. I don't know if it's your artwork. I don't know what it is, but it's time for you to pick it back up. Because once you pick it up, when you pick it up, it's your answer. Right now, see, it's sometimes hard to see because the enemy tries to mess with the mind first. He gets into the mind and he says, you can't do this. You can't do this. Yes, I can. You've got to begin to say, yes, I can. Whatever it is, yes, I can. I can do this. And God is going to give you the strength to be able to do it, mother. Because that's where your breakthrough is coming.
Yes, Lord.
But what happens is I push against the breakthrough because I don't understand it. Mm-hmm. Everything seems like it's going crazy around me. My whole world is falling apart. God says sometimes the world got to fall apart so it can be built back up. God is not only just working through Dominique, he's also working on your other children just as well. Mm-hmm. It seems like all hell is breaking loose with the total package. See, it never just starts with one. It's always the total package. Because you've been carrying this seed for a long time. But you carry a lot of their hurts and a lot of their pains and a lot of their struggles. Well, you got to let go of their pain. Let go of their struggles. Because he can deal with them with their struggles and their pains. Because he gives you where you're at. So that you can be free. God is trying to bring this union back together. And the enemy doesn't want you. Don't want y'all to see the union. And I'm talking about the total package.
Yeah.
I mean, even Devin. Devin is going through hell and back. Devin is going through hell and back. Now, I don't even know. Haven't talked to Devin. Haven't seen Devin. Seen him one time at the mall, and that's that. A long time ago. But Devin is going through hell and back. Why? Because God is doing something through Devin. But the enemy is fighting Devin at the same time. Because the enemy don't want Devin to get his fullness. He doesn't want Dwayne to get his fullness. Mm. So what he does, he messes with the total package. Because all hell to break loose so that we don't understand. God, can you really set our family free? Can you really bring our family back together? Can you really do this? Mm. And all the time God is saying, yes, I can. I did it. I was the one. I was the one who predestinated everything. Mm. So it's not your steps. It's not her steps. It's not Dwayne's steps. It's not Devin steps, is God stepping to put everything in order. Mm-hmm. And every time he's put it to order, something happens. Why are we going backwards, God, when it seems like we're going forwards? Because all hell is breaking loose. But things to be set free, put things in order. But mother, you've got to pick it up. Whatever it is that God's calling you to pick it up, you got to do it. You got to. Because that's where your answer's going to come from. your mind seems, listen, ooh, God, look, you, your mind is trying to lose itself. Your mind is literally trying to lose itself. You're losing your mind. And this is what the enemy's telling you. You're losing your mind, things are going crazy.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Fresh oil.
Thank you, Lord.
You took a step of faith this morning, even in your hurt and your pain and other things that may have to go on. You cried out. And God is pulling you in. God is pulling you in. Things are changing, Mom. And it's for you. You've been asking for this. You've been asking God, God, take me. God, I need to know where I'm supposed to be. Where do I fit into this puzzle?
You have a great way to carry this puzzle.
Even with inside your heart. God wants you to be free. Inside your heart. Because you've been carrying things even from the past still. And little by little, it's happening. Little by little, things is happening. Just continue to get in there. Continue to do just what you did today. Continue to stand and proclaim your victory just like you did today. I'm free. I'm free. This ain't happening to my mind. I got a right mind. I'm in a good mind. My mind is okay. God's got my mind. I'm flowing in His Spirit. Begin to speak those things just like what you said today. And the more you do it, the more you do it, the more you do it. Woo, I'm telling you, God is good. Oh, He's working on you. But you've got a greater purpose in you. You even got a greater power purpose right ahead of you. It's right there. You got a greater purpose. And I'm telling you, Mom, oh yeah, I can see that job. You got that greater purpose. It's right there. It's right there. It's right there. Continue to do what you're doing. Continue to declare it. Continue to keep proclaiming it. Continue to keep moving in. And I'm telling, oh yeah, greater. Oh yeah, you ain't seen it yet, but it's right there. It's right there. You watch. Oh, Mom, watch what's gonna happen. I'm telling you. Watch what's gonna happen. Watch. It's right there. It's right there. This is awesome. Oh, it's awesome. Woo, it's awesome. She said, just like what you said this morning, so that you gotta stand in the midst of your story. You, even when the storm comes, sometimes God allows you to stand in the midst of the storm and proclaim something to somebody else. And it changes them, but at the same time, it changes
you. Occasionally, I hear a lot of stuff. But He said, because the kids have stopped coming, doesn't mean you're done giving birth. That's all He said. He said, because the kids have stopped and it's grown, it doesn't mean that you're done giving birth. There's going to be people with visions that don't understand visions, but you're going to give birth to the dream and then they'll get the vision. They're going to get what He's been trying to tell them. And through giving birth, through pushing forth like you've already given birth this morning, He said, this morning you've already pushed forth. You've already pushed forth the very seed that's been put in you, that depression trying to stop.
Yes.
That bipolarness or whatever trying to stop, that Satan's been trying to stop for years. He said, you've already pushed it out. And He said, a lot of things that you're going to push out, don't worry about it. A lot of things that you're going to give birth to, good things, don't worry about it. He's going to put caretakers in place. Because if you allow your mind to get wrapped up on all of it, of course we can't take care of all of these things by ourselves. He said He's going to put all the caretakers in place. He's going to use mother to push them out, though. He's going to use mother to push them out. Hallelujah. 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 People are going to come to you again with, man, I got this, I got that. He's going to use you to push it out. And then they will begin to take care of their own dream. But the dream is going to come from you. the very visions that God has given other people that they cannot get out. You're going to push them forth, and then they're going to, oh, that's what it is. I can take care of it. It's like drawing or doing your art. You push it all out, and then you show it to somebody. Wait, that's me. Whoa, that's what God was saying. He said, get ready to give birth and push forth many things. And through those things, you will be blessed. Your physical children will be blessed. And the children that are even yours will be blessed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just say, don't worry about that. I hear that. Don't worry about who's going to take care of you. People are going to be set in place to take care of everything that you've done. Hallelujah.
And just think about if you would have gave up during your downtime where somebody else would be here.
Thank you, Jesus.
Seriously.
Come on.
You think about that.
Yep.
Come on.
You think about the life that each of us have given to each other.
Yep.
And if we weren't there for each other, there in our dark time.
Yep.
Think about how we're still connected. And we don't have to be connected.
Come on.
That's a powerful thing. Just think if you would have gave up.